So we've got some TPs coming towards the top lane. It's R-Style running in. Mag's on his way to R-Style popping the ult, but just to extend that night time. Thinking about going on TC. TC is nice and close, so there goes the silence on him. See, Lashrak gets a stun as well. Nice Gale going to go through TC, eating damage as well, but Avalanche Toss does so much back. And Mike also still in the midst here. Artstyle, one last boy, just pick off the Tiny. So well worth that trade. Now I'm hearing a charge is going on Fluff and stuff. Arstyle, he's got one more Void. VS with a stun, in comes God, but he gets stopped by the Ravage. Then the Anchor Smash as well. Han Montana stopping Dera in their tracks. And he'll look down towards Mag. At the same time, God, as well as Goblack, looking for the pickoff on the side. Trap going to go through. And Geo gets a wonderful tornado, sending God as well as Goblack up into the air. And there's a jump on through. Will he get out in time? No, he doesn't. Spirit Breaker goes down. Mike being hunted by the TA. And he should be able to get the last right click in there. Double kill now for Goblin. Now he's going to look over towards Hannah Montana, picking up the creeps as he goes to. Nice trap. Still got some decent amount to play around with, not to mention the bottle charge. It's Funix back here again. Looks for the stun. Gets it on Hannah Montana. So we have a triple kill now for Goblin. He does get it too. Now over onto Geo. Avalanche missing there from TC. And Goblin lays out the trap. Slows down TC. Funix going to look for a secondary stun. Cannot get it, but he does actually. The tornado does cancel a little bit of the animation of it, but the stun still flew. Now they look towards TC. Void trying to go up there by R-Style. Chasing down TC. There goes a trap, both on Geo as well as TC. Avalanche hits on both Goblin as well as R-Style. Still in through the side. Funnick wants another hit, and he's going to do it too. TA getting down Tiny. VS stops down the Templar Assassin. And now the charge, hamming again. In comes God, and he does get the kill on Ventral to rip before Flub and stuff, sends his body back again. Now Geo's on the run from God, back to the Tier 2 tower. It's the only real safe place now, but maybe not even safe right now.
TB.
The Tier 1. TB onto the Tier 1. Hannah Montana's back. Gush on a mag. There may be a bit of a lucky bash for God. Not going to happen. He's going to run himself away from this one. This fight should end right now. So they know something is up. And even the wolves coming out. And the smoke is up from my E-Home. Havorst, because the wolves are on the other side, they had some vision. Storm going to jump in.
Oh,
wonderful
Shackle!
In with the Epi! In with the Quap Ultimate! And Na'Vi, QQQ will go down as well. At least goes Ravage up in this one. But the Medallion bringing down X. Shackle will fly and latches again. Light of Heaven is on fire right now. Morphling the only one to survive, and Lam has no idea what to do back at base. In fact, he even brought back to be involved in that. That's a team wipe for all of Shrek.
The carry potential from Black might mess with them a little bit, as we've seen Orchid eventually come out of him, but it's so delayed now that Anti-Mage might even be close to his Manta style by the time the Orchid is up, or at least getting semi-close to it, and from then on, Orchid is just not as usable. The silence comes, and then he immediately just drops you as the gank goes in on Black. Queen of Pain shot up as well. Shuriken toss. He's still alive though. 23 HP. He's bottling through it. There's the hook. Anti-Mage is going to get picked up. They're going to save him. I can't believe it. Going after Bounty Hunter. Ulti from Bambo as well. Ulti on Bounty Hunter. Oh my gosh. They pick him up. Double kill.
What a turnaround. Black going to survive. And, well, the two kills on Anti-Mage and Bounty Hunter. Two very important kills. Queen of Pain, of course, still alive. That's an important hero as well. But what a play coming out from that.
I think Bamboo missed it. He missed his Melt Strike. I think Bamboo missed it because he used it.
Ah, Koro! Shackled to his own Forged Spirit. Now going with the Cold Snap and Blood Angel, who pops off the Wind Run so he can try and keep up. All he wanted was buy time for Vigos to catch up. Shackles off cooldown, and in 1-0, Koro got to keep himself away from trees. Now successfully do.
What?
What? What is that shackle? Lone Druid goes down as well on the bot lane, but that shackle went down the tree in the river!
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Maybe they even think about mid lane. XY, man, he's actually taken back now. Telekin is gonna grab DDC.
Oh,
four seconds stun on him. Then the Fable. Storm gonna jump in. Big Quap Baldi. Darkseer walls up as well. Not the best position for Zenith to find, but IXY, he steals out the Quap Baldi so he can damage back out again. And now, this is real trouble for LGD. They've already lost three for the prize of Ice. It is perfect for Zenith. There goes the Darkseer as well. And DD out too far. Is there another stun? There's a Hex on Loader. HY using whatever mana he's got left to jump in on DD.
Oh,
and he got a
water
trap on HY, but he'll jump out only just enough mana to get away. And XY, he's going to go down to the tower. The tower will take
no
him down.
No smoke!
Perfect timing from him. Gets out of vision, which means there is no way to hit.
14-37 is just keeping an eye on the fact. I think he decides that carrying the XP between three heroes at bottom is not going to accomplish much. He's not really sure they can get it from Weaver, but Weaver has kept his place so far. Perfectly at his tally, he has now.
Oh my god. He did it. He gushed the Darkseer when he was low HP and surrounded by four neutrals. Such good play. I can hear the screams from the kitchen. Oh my god.
And interesting to see Arthur's really wanting to go on Dendi there.
Oh man, he's gonna get it too. Riptide Dendi orbs away.
I don't see the point of what he's
doing. And now he got what? He tried to drop the ulti on Arsalt! That looks so in range! And now he can't get it, the Riptide 16 HP, the crew's gonna play it! Oh, the ult! Oh, Dendi! Naga just needed one swing of the blade! And Dendi would be gone from the face of the earth!
Yeah, the position of their heroes is way behind the tier 2. Black is the only buddy person showing right now. Even Kuroki putting in a ward on the high ground. He's going to vacuum on 3. The Black Hole catches all 3 kills. Well, the AoE, here comes the Anti-Mage ulti. He tried to cast it, but they die too fast as Panda drops as well. Now after the Weaver, who goes invisible. But they just wiped 3 heroes for 1 AoE ultimate. That was absolutely insane pickup there. That's going to guarantee them at least this tier 2 tower.
Dear love the wards!
Ding ding!
One ward to watch him run up the river, and they're watching him so closely. If he gets a good Gale, Gale goes out in DD, so they're focusing Lutrak down to start with, and the spin. This should be first blood. Did he just stun him up on towards the high ground?
No!
DDC! You do not get that for free, and Universe is in the worst possible position right now. Caught up on the high ground.
And no one, does anyone have any gold to buy TP score? No, nobody's got money. Yeah, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean. And this now means that this aggressive tri-lane can't work. It has been denied as well.
Because this is aggressive dual lane now.
So Universe has to wait, but even then, they can't get the ward, the TP up to him. They need a flying courier.
Will forever be hidden.
Are they gonna go Roshan? Navi's grouping up for Roshan. I suppose if Avos gets some deets and crits, that should be fast enough.
Oh, bad idea for. That's a very bad idea. Because if Hao gets a perfect ultimate up there, so screwed.
Yep. And what have we currently got up? We've got Phantom Strike currently up for Rubik. So he's a quick jump in. With a killing off Roshan down a half life. In comes Tong Fu. They are all watching the movement.
Yes.
There we go. Na'Vi is locked. Wards to go down. The prep is there. And Na'Vi Puppy will have to turn around for the biggest flag of his life. 1 second, 0 second. Now he can black call. What a wall! And into the back! Huge hit on Tong Fu! They've lost 3! They've lost 4! In the disaster! They've lost 5! Na'Vi! It could have been amazing for Tong Fu! But what a play by Light of Heaven and Puppy! Disintegrating Tong Fu!
Best pipe ever.
Oh!
For there is some